morning students. I am Prerna Seth. Today we will study about the topic active and passive voice. But students, before we start studying about active and passive voice, I would like to tell you some basic things about the sentence. As you know students, a complete sentence can be formed with a subject and a verb. For example, dogs bark, he sneezed, birds fly, snakes crawl. These sentences can be called complete sentences as they have a subject and a verb. But you know students, there are some sentences also that have an object. For example, the dogs barked at the stranger, he kicked the ball. The cat jumped the tree. The man opened the door. All of these sentences have an object. And students, they can be transformed into passive voice. Clear students? But before we start learning active and passive voice, I would like to give you some basic knowledge about subject and an object. The person who does the action is called subject. For example, Ram is eating an apple. In this sentence, who is eating an apple? Ram. So Ram is subject in this sentence. The thing on which action is applied to is called an object. There are two types of object. And students, they are direct object and indirect object. Indirect object is living being and direct object is non-living thing. And secondly, when we apply whom in a sentence, then we get indirect object, and when we apply what in a sentence, then we get direct object. You can understand with the help of these examples. For example, we are teaching you. Whom are we teaching? The answer is you. So you is an indirect object and it is also a living being. In the same way, what are we teaching you? We are teaching you English. The answer is English. So English is a direct object. Now students, you are able to differentiate between indirect object and direct object. I hope you are able to understand. When we apply who in a sentence, we get our subject. When we apply whom in a sentence, we get indirect object. And when we apply what in a sentence, we get direct object. Let's try to find out subject and object in these sentences. They are playing hockey. Ram is telling a lie. Shyam is singing a song. They are buying fruits from the shop. Meera has painted a beautiful picture. Maya got the prize in the competition. Mr. Sharma teaches us grammar and she is giving me a story book. In the first one, they are playing hockey. Who are playing? They. So they is subject. What are they playing? They are playing hockey. So hockey is direct object. Ram is telling a lie. Who is telling a lie? Ram. Ram is our subject. What is he telling? A lie. A lie is a direct object. Shyam is singing a song. Shyam is, who is singing a song? Shyam. So Shyam is subject. What is he singing? A song. So a song is direct object. Who are buying fruits? They. So they is subject. And what are they buying? They are buying fruits. Fruits is our direct object. Meera has painted a beautiful picture. Who has painted? Meera. So Meera is our subject. What has Meera painted? A beautiful picture. A beautiful picture is our direct object. Maya got the prize in the competition. Who got the prize? Maya. So Maya is subject. What did she get? She got the prize. The prize is direct object. Pay attention students. In the next sentence, there are two types of object. Mr. Sharma teaches us grammar. Who teaches us grammar? Mr. Sharma. whom does he teach? Us. So us is a indirect object, and what does he teach? He teaches us grammar. Grammar is direct object. She is giving me a storybook. Who is giving a storybook? She. So she is subject. Whom is she giving? Me. So me is an object, indirect object. And what is she giving? She is giving a storybook. So a storybook is a direct object.